The U.S. Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, has revealed that its Skyborg Autonomy Core System, or ACS, successfully completed a flight with a General Atomics Avenger unmanned vehicle at Edwards Air Force Base in California. The Skyborg-controlled Avenger flew for 2.5 hours on June 24, 2021, during the Orange Flag 21-2 Large Force test event at Edwards Air Force Base. Viewers may note that Orange Flag is a training event held by the 412th Test Wing 3 times a year that focuses on technical integration and innovation across a breadth of technology readiness levels, as per the U.S. Air Force press release. The Avenger's flight at Orange Flag was part of the AFRL's larger Autonomous Attritable Aircraft Experimentation AAAx project. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Skyborg program operating Avenger drone autonomously could be a significant force multiplier for the U.S. Air Force. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. As per reports, a human operator initiated the flight and got the Avenger to a safe altitude, and then handed it off to the Skyborg pilot. A command and control station on the ground monitored the drone's flight, and Skyborg executed a series of foundational behaviors necessary to characterize safe system operation, including following navigational commands, flying within defined boundaries known as geofences, adhering to safe flight envelopes, and demonstrating coordinated maneuvering. The main aim of this test was to validate if Skyborg ACS was able to safely control Avenger and guide it to conduct a few basic maneuvers within a defined area. This event adds a new aircraft that Skyborg has flown successfully. Earlier, the service has used a Kratos UTAP-22 Mako unmanned aircraft to conduct the first flight test of an initial version of the AI-driven computer brain being developed under the Skyborg program. Viewers may note that the Skyborg project is supported by Kratos, Boeing, and General Atomics, which are under contract to provide UAVs for this initiative. U.S. Air Force Life Cycle Management Center, AFL-CMC, and the U.S. Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, are working together to manage the Skyborg program, which was publicly revealed in 2019. As part of that goal, the Skyborg program is developing an artificial intelligence-driven computer brain that could eventually autonomously control drones or unmanned combat air vehicles, UCAVs. The focus currently is on the Skyborg Autonomy Core System, ACS, and the idea is to have it perform tasks such as taking off and landing and undertaking some basic decisions autonomously. The U.S. Air Force 2022 fiscal year budget request, which was released on May 28, 2021, as part of the larger proposed budget for the U.S. military as a whole for that fiscal cycle, identified the Skyborg initiative as one of the service's vanguard efforts. The service first revealed the concept of the Vanguard program last year. Any initiative tagged as Vanguard program is expected to require advanced research and development. The others are Rocket Cargo Program, the Golden Horde Networked Swarming Munitions Project, and the Navigation Technology Satellite 3, NTS-3, effort. General Atomics Avenger, formerly Predator C, is developed from MQ-9 Reaper, Predator B drone. Unlike the previous MQ-1 Predator and MQ-9 Reaper drones, the Avenger is powered by a turbofan engine, and its design includes stealth features such as internal weapon storage and an S-shaped exhaust for reduced infrared and radar signatures. It can carry the Lynx synthetic aperture radar and a version of the F-35 Lightning II's electro-optical targeting system, EOTS, called the Advanced Low Observable Embedded Reconnaissance Target, Alert System. It has internal weapons bay with 3,500 pounds or 1,600 kilograms capacity and 6 external hardpoints. The drone has a total payload capacity of 6,500 pounds or 2,900 kilograms. The platform is compatible with AGM-114 Hellfire missiles, GBU-39SDB, 250-pound or 110-kilogram bombs, GBU-12 Paveway 2, GBU-38 JDAM 500-pound or 230-kilogram bombs, GBU-16 Paveway 2, GBU-32 JDAM 1,000-pound 450-kilogram bombs, and GBU-31 JDAM 2,000-pound or 910-kilogram bombs. The Avenger uses the same ground support infrastructure as the MQ-1 and MQ-9, including the ground control station and existing communications networks. Avenger is a much more capable and complex platform compared to Kratos UTAP-22 Mako unmanned aircraft, which was flown earlier. So, autonomous operation of this platform is an excellent achievement. Managing a single Avenger with basic operations is the first step. Ultimately, the U.S. Air Force will like to have the Skyborg-powered UAVs to operate both completely autonomously and in networked groups. Avenger brings certain capabilities that would be critical in future wars. Its stealthy design makes it less vulnerable to air defense systems, and its weapons payload could enable it to take out high-value targets. Also, U.S. Air Force has been considering adding air-to-air weaponry to its drones, dating back as far as 2003. AIM-9X, developed by Raytheon, is likely to be integrated for certain missions. It has a speed of Mach 2.5, range of 22 miles or 35 kilometers, has infrared homing for guidance, and a 9.4 kilogram warhead. Autonomously flying Avengers or Reapers armed with this kind of weaponry would be a major game changer.